lecturer of clinical oncology at Shams University and head of organizing committee for the Breast Gynae Oncology International Cancer Conference. On behalf of all the BGICC scientific board, it's a great honor to have everyone. I know that everyone is coming from different country and he has already commitments to accept our invitation to start our initiative, which is the Pan-African Cancer Alliance. It's a platform to collaborate all of us from different countries, different cultures, different organizations, for one reason, which is to fight against cancer and to collaborate in different aspects of oncology, which is education, research, and patient advocacy. And we are so honored to have top eminent figures in Africa in this aspects, which is the research, education, and patient advocacy. And not Africa also, we have from Europe, Professor Murat Golkin, who he's so generous to accept our invitation and to join us in our meeting. We can start by introducing everyone, and then Professor Hussein can start his talk.
Yes. Hello, good night. Good afternoon, between good afternoon and good night. I'm a professor in Turkey, in gynae oncology, especially working in prevention area, and currently leading in the board of European Society of Gynae Oncology. But this is my scientific part. But I also do a lot of job in advocacy, especially in Europe and in my country. And someone who believes that without advocacy, nobody, neither science nor politicians, can be successful. So happy and proud to have this invitation and to be with you. So maybe I can bring the microphone to you and then at the end. Yes. Saying, okay.
Thank you. I'm a pathologist from Morocco. I'm Professor Basma Khanoussi. I'm head of Department of Pathology in National Institute of Oncology in Rabat from Morocco. And I'm happy to be with you.
And Dr. Narjis Brada, I'm a medical oncologist from Morocco. I'm the general secretary of the Moroccan Association of Oncologists and also the coordinator of Africa Breast University, which is French courses, which done by which done every year in June.
Hi, I'm Al-Abrar Ibrahim. I'm a master degree of clinical oncology and nuclear medicine, Alexandria University, and from Sudan. And I'm here to attend the conference. Thanks for the invitation.
Hi, I'm Dr. Osman Kamil. I'm a public health expert and health economics. That was in my past life. Now I work in public health and health economics.
Okay, my name is Salome Eferemo. I'm from Nigeria. I am a trained theater artist and a media consultant. I'm applying my specialty to advocacy for the elimination of cervical cancer in Africa, starting with Nigeria with a pilot project, children and them. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Awad Mohammed Abu Samin. I am a radiation oncologist consultant radiation from the National Cancer Institute, Libya, and also I am the member in the scientific committee of the Libyan board radiotherapy and the faculty of medicine at Misrata. And I am happy to join with you, and I wish you for all the best luck.
Hello, I'm Dr. Mohammed bin Saoud. I'm head of Radiation Oncology Department at NCI Libya.
My name is Isra. I'm a cancer patient advocate from Egypt and founder of We Want Life and member of Inspire to Live, global advocacy group.
Hello, everybody. My name is Ilona Scheller, and I'm from Amsterdam, the Netherlands, and I'm from Inspire to Live, the global advocacy group. I'm a I'm the COO of Inspire to Live.
Good evening, good night, everybody. Sorry for the delay. We are here tonight to start some sort of coalition or gathering for helping our population. And whatever we link the science with the services, that is very important, and the research and education. So if you would like to tackle the issues in cancer separately, they will not going to be any success. So I'm Dr. Hussien Maki, Associated Professor of Clinical Oncology, General Director of Khartoum Oncology Specialized Center, and Ambassador and Representative of the BISS in very catastrophic African zone in sub-Saharan Africa. And we will see these issues. According to the United Nations, sub-Saharan Africa consists of all African countries that are fully or partially located south of the Sahara. It includes six different geographical areas. That means very wide area that we're dealing in this society with very huge area. And we started our efforts years ago. And I think Dr. Nergis' brother is responsible for the North Africa and Moroccan or Atlas Mountains. I think I'm responsible for this area under supervision of Professor Hisham and Dr. Narmin. And we started many times some sort of collaboration. And this year we have become more serious to start this subject by starting the Pan-African Cancer Alliance. And we had a meeting before with ESGO, Professor Murad is already, and the BIG, another society, trying to find a way and to pick the way how we can support our population and how we can find solutions for the different problems. No one can achieve everything in 1 year, but we're starting to build our efforts for long-term project. The total number of the countries, about 52, and total number of population, about a third of the world population. Sub-Saharan Africa have more than 1,000 languages, about one-sixth of the world total, many different ethnics and religions, and that will reflect the different stigma, the different opinions, the different myths, the different concepts regarding the cancer. And different tribes, different ethnicities, and different religions, that means there is a big problem. The cancer in this area, in this zone, it is not just a medical problem. It could be some sort of evil problem. It could be some sort of community problem rather than medical problem. High illiteracy level, about 27% of illiterate global population. And this is the area I'm working on. So thank you very much for making this gathering this year to support the efforts. So the global map presenting incidence and mortality rates by the world countries for breast cancer in females in all ages in 2013 in GlobalCan. And if you can see that the incidence is more common of the breast cancer in the West, the incidence in the West, while Africa is little is compared with the West and Latin America. But if you go the mortality, you will see very high mortality rate in our zone in sub-Saharan Africa. So low incidence in the West, in Africa compared to the West, but the mortality rate is very huge. So the most common cancer cases, and this is in sub-Saharan Africa, both sexes combined 2018 from the global count, an estimated 4% of global total, much diseases diagnosed as the breast cancer. And although the over cancer burden in the region is dominated by the breast, cervical, and prostatic cancer. And this is the diagram, breast on top, then cervix, prostate, liver, Kaposi sarcoma, lung, esophagus, and stomach. So challenging facts in sub-Saharan Africa. What are the challenging facts here in this zone? What is the problem in this zone? So number one, breast cancer cases diagnosed in advanced stages with high mortality rate. And if you would like to construct our guidelines in the BGICS for sub-Saharan Africa, we should put in mind how we can minimize and how we can help in the early detection and fight the different and stigma regarding the disease. Another factor, or one third, and I should speak about cervical cancer here. Over one third of the cervical cancer deaths globally occurs in sub-Saharan Africa. So the region represents only 14% of world female population. So topic about breast cancer, but it is very significant and very serious. We should speak about the cervical cancer, because if we could control the both diseases in sub-Saharan Africa, that means we control more than 50 or 60% of the cancer problem in this region. Infectious predisposing factors to cancer is common in sub-Saharan Africa if compared to the global view. And limited guiding studies for dealing with cancer issues related to population in this geographical zone. There are limited studies conducted, limited in genetic analysis, limitation, and the most studies are retrospective studies, unfortunately. We should start to go for prospective studies to analyze the different parts of the genes for this population and how we can benefit from the different types of molecular targeted therapies which can help in this population. Because the ethnicity is totally different from the West. And so to some extent, you can find the triple negative to some extent, very aggressive in the African American women. So we would like to do some sort of much studies and prospective studies, not retrospective studies. And I think this is one of the recommendations by end of this gathering, that how we can start to help this zone. In the BGICS, I think we're not just we are meeting each year to gain the knowledge. We should have an input to our communities. So thank you very much, Professor Hisham and Dr. Narmeen, for making this gathering. And it's a very hard job to work in sub-Saharan Africa. But this year, very serious job started, and we can do the job over years. And the last thing, that directing the resources is the main problem rather than availability of the resources. Africa is not limited in the resources, by the way. They have much resources, but how we can control and direct the resources? If we could direct these resources in the right way, we could achieve treatment, education, better quality of life. So these are the challenging facts in this zone. Leading causes of cancer deaths in sub-Saharan Africa and associated risk factors, top is cervical cancer and the breast cancer. So if we could control these two diseases in sub-Saharan Africa, we're going to have great success in fighting and eliminating the cancer. So critical situation factors. Lack of awareness and screening programs about cancer, limited primary health care problems. These are our problems in sub-Saharan Africa. They are limited in the primary health care services. Much attention toward the other communicable diseases, malaria, tuberculosis, and HIV. The large size of the zone, 52 countries, that mean different political opinions, that mean different myths, different beliefs. We should speak common language. We should deal with through the representative of each region, with each country, to have our main theme. And we are not in a rush to achieve that immediately. I think such project is going to take long years. So public media have less impact on cancer awareness issues. Radio is still the main popular method in this part of African continent. Another critical situation factor, the poverty. Unstable political situation in this zone, which reflect directly on the health policies. Wars and borders conflict, corruption, and lack of proper financial regulations. Lack of social community development programs. So these what are we have in this area. Number three, illiteracy. There is still lack of education and literacy. negative mind and beliefs about the disease, stigma, and discrimination. So the cancer in sub-Saharan Africa, International Agency for Research on Cancer has emphasized the critical importance of population-based cancer registries in providing the evidence base to inform cancer control policy and to drive cancer research. And the cancer registry is one of the main problems in this zone. Most of them are institutional and not capitalized or the whole country or the whole Africa. Cancer is an increasing problem in Africa because of a gaining and growth of population as well as changing prevalence of the risk factor associated with social and economic transition. The need for functional cancer surveillance system is evident in all documents relating to cancer control planning, as is the essential role of cancer registries in the context of low and middle income countries, given the changing landscape of cancer burden and cancer surveillance. In 2012, the African Cancer Registry Network was formally structured for registries with deficit set of membership criteria, becoming the regional network hub for sub-Saharan Africa in the same year. African Cancer Registry Network aims to improve the effectiveness of cancer surveillance in sub-Saharan Africa by providing expert evaluation of current problems and technical support of the identified barriers. This is some sort of light to start some sort of registry. Even if it is minimal, the side effects, it's not complete, it's not competent, but I think this is a light. We should carry out the previous efforts and we can build on it for the future. Now the PGICS started to the Pan-African Cancer Alliance, and we have a mission, and this mission is aim, and we have plans and strategies. So the aim, add positive values, energies, and efforts regarding early detection activities and cancer researches to get more beneficial impact on general cancer situation and treatment mission in this geographical zone. And the plan and strategies, number one, the professional networking, adoption of ongoing established policies, establishing focal active points and coordinators, and the strategies to achieve these plans is start contact with health authorities, contact voluntary groups and private sector, connecting other societies and working groups. Enhance early detection efforts, strengthen concepts of early detection, build up skills for early detection, build up community engagement. And we have strategies for achieving this plan, is agreed materials with different language, training for primary health workers, training for activists and leaders, establish mobile units and teams. Number three, enhance scientific researches, ethnic groups and genetic mutation difference, molecular characteristics, and demographic and epidemiological status. Connect and encouraging the multinational companies and international institutions and groups and societies with global missions to share their research effort in this zone. Enhance the treatment capabilities, build up capabilities for professional training, programs for new technologies in radiation therapy, comprehensive courses, manipulation of the international guidelines with local accessible situation and services. And I hope we can achieve these aims through the time. Thank you very much. For Pan-African?
Yeah,
is responsible?
Yeah, who is responsible for the plan? Who is going to lead the plan?
Okay, thank you very much for this question. Actually, we started the opinion with Professor Hisham and Dr. Narmin, and we started to make something different in our continent. And also, already we have as a society different regions and departments. BGICS is the founding body for the Pan-African Cancer Alliance. And we start to ask the other people to be import from different countries. And at the same time, we do not like to touch the other, like the awards, for example. They will go back. We start slowly this year, and we just need to implement, to implant the ideas in the different minds, and we go
And we want to make it for all cancers, breast cancer, cervix, Professor Ashraf for HCC. So let me introduce my special and great professor and mentor. He's international world leader in HCC, Professor Ashraf Omar. He is the president of Egyptian Society of Liver Cancers. He's also the editor for the Hepatocellular Cancer Journal.